Hi there and welcome to Hyundai Power Equipment. Today we're going to look at the box contents and a bit of assembly of your HY1000 inverter generator from Hyundai Power Equipment. Okay, so we'll open the box. First of all, you'll find your user guide. Now, it's essential that you read this before use. For filling your inverter with oil, we supply an oil jug. Requires a little amount of assembly, but it's pretty simple as you can see. You screw the spout on, and that's it, it's away to go. Also in the box, you'll find a bottle of fuel additive. This helps increase the petrol lifespan when not in use or left for long periods. A bottle of Morris lubricants, it's 15W40 engine oil, and a 230-volt fly lead. Next, we have the toolkit. In the toolkit, you will find a double-ended screwdriver, a set of 12-volt charger leads for charging external batteries, which plugs into the control panel, and finally, a spark plug spanner. Okay, we'll just pack these away for safekeeping. Finally, we have the main generator unit. And there we have it. Next, we'll go through how to prepare the generator for use. So first of all, we need to remove the maintenance hatch. Okay, to do this, we need to remove this screw using the double-ended screwdriver provided. And as you can see, this end of the screwdriver is the flat blade. We need the crosshead blade, but you simply rotate the head so that the crosshead blade is in your handle. So, turning the screw anti-clockwise, we can remove the screw like so. We'll draw it completely and keep it safe, and then starting from the top down, we can remove the maintenance hatch. In the bottom left-hand corner, you'll see the oil filler and dipstick, which is a combined unit. I'll just show you that. This is it here. Unscrew the oil filler cap anti-clockwise to remove, and then withdraw it. You'll also find attached on the oil filler cap is the dipstick itself. Using the oil supplied, or a 1040 engine oil, fill the oil jug with oil, like so. Simply pour oil into the top of the filler neck. Be careful not to overfill this. Do it in a few sort of intervals, if required, to avoid overfilling. Once the oil is right to the top of the filler neck, when the machine is level, refit the filler cap. I'll just show you the position where it needs to be. That's the amount of oil we need, right to the top of the filler neck. And replace the filler cap. You can do this up fairly tightly because we want to avoid any oil leaks. Next thing to do is to replace the maintenance cover. Starting from the bottom in the little grooves, put it back into position and replace the screw, turning it clockwise to tighten. The next thing to do is add fuel. Remove the fuel cap and fill the generator with fresh unleaded petrol. You can use a fuel additive, such as the one supplied to extend the petrol life, but no two-stroke additives or anything like that. It's just fresh and leaded petrol, this being a four-stroke machine. We recommend draining the fuel from the inverter when storing for long periods of time to avoid the fuel turning stale. So if you're going to store it for a long period, run it out of fuel or drain the fuel from it. Refit the fuel cap, ensuring that the fuel cap air vent is set to the on position during use. When not in use, set the fuel cap air vent to the off position. When starting, place the engine switch to the on position and move the choke lever to the start position. Pull gently on the starter cord until you feel resistance, and then pull it briskly to start the generator like so. Make sure you don't pull the recoil cord too hard, as this could cause damage to the recoil assembly. So I'll just switch the economy switch to on, so we're on economy, saving fuel. And this is the cycle button for the LCD display. And as you can see, if I push it, it goes through a cycle. Total runtime, engine speed, output volts and frequency, back to total runtime. And if I just keep pushing, it'll go back to the output so I can monitor it. There we are, 233 and 50 hertz. This is the 12 volt external socket, and this is the 230 volt socket. To stop the engine, simply turn the engine switch on the side to off. As you can see, the 12-volt lead plugs in here. Should you overload the 12 volt circuit, the red reset button will pop out. To reset it, or just simply push it in and it will click into position. Before plugging in any heavy load appliances, make sure the economy switch is set to the off position. Under normal conditions, place the economy switch in the on position. As a quick summary of how to prepare your machine for use, first of all, put oil in the machine. Secondly, fill the machine with fuel. Turn the fuel cap air vent to the on position. Ensure the engine switch is in the on position. Move the choke lever to the start position. Pull gently on the starter cord until you feel resistance, and then pull briskly to start the generator. Once started, return the choke lever to the run position once the engine has run for 5 to 10 seconds or so. Before plugging in any heavy load appliances, make sure the economy switch is set to the off position. Under normal conditions, place the economy switch to the on position. To turn the generator off, turn the engine switch to the off position. For more helpful videos, hints and tips, visit HyundaiPowerEquipment.co.uk. Thank you for watching. I've been Adrian, and happy generating!